important in Hong Kong are not something that we have to be particularly concerned about. We'll look at different ways to promote waste paper recycling.
Government Bill, first reading. Banking Amendment Bill 2017, second reading. Secretary for Financial Services and the Treasury. President, I move the second reading of the Banking Amendment Bill 2017. The bill seeks to strengthen the resilience of our banking system through implementing the latest international regulatory standards on recovery planning and limitations on financial exposure. The financial crisis in recent years have highlighted the inadequacy of financial institutions in preparing for severe stress events. To address this vulnerability, the Financial Stability Board, established by the G20 leaders, issued in 2014 a set of standards relating to recovery planning. The standards specify that supervisory authorities should ensure that financial institutions maintain a recovery plan with options to restore financial strength and viability when they come under severe stress. The authorities should also have the requisite powers to mandate the implementation of recovery measures. At present, the MA has to rely on the information gathering power under the Banking Ordinance to require AIs to prepare recovery plans. To enhance transparency and certainty, we propose to prescribe explicit recovery planning requirements in the ordinance to empower MA to require AIs to draw up and implement a recovery plan. This will ensure compliance with the relevant FSB standards and, more importantly, the resilience of our banking system to cope with severe stress. The bill also seeks to update the present financial exposure limits for banks. Under the Banking Ordinance, AIs are subject to a set of restrictions on the financial exposures they may incur, which will prevent their exposures from becoming overly concentrated in certain aspects. The current exposure limits follow the standards promulgated by the Basel Committee on Banking Supervision in 1991. Following the BCBS's release of a new supervisory framework for measuring and controlling large exposures in April 2014, Hong Kong is obliged to update our regulatory regime based on the latest standards. Implementing the new large exposures framework requires amendments to the Banking Ordinance to remove obsolete provisions and institute replacement rules. In view of the new framework's technical nature and that such regulatory requirements updated from time to time to reflect changes in international standards, we propose to remove the relevant provisions in the primary legislation and instead confer a general power on the MA to make rules to prescribe limits on exposures. This approach is in line with that adopted for implementing the BCBS's capital disclosure and liquidity standards. President, on the 16th of March, we have consulted the Financial Affairs Panel on these legislative proposals. We have also consulted the banking sector. Both support the proposals. I hope that the Legislative Council can pass this bill as soon as possible so that we can implement in time these international banking regulatory standards in banking, boost Hong Kong's status as an international financial standard, and enhance our credibility as a member of the BCBS and FSB. So I speak. Thank you. First, I now propose the question to you. I am reading out the bill. Can you take a seat first? President, I move the second reading of. I now propose the question to you that the Banking Amendment Bill 2017 be read the second time. Mr. Eddie Chu, please put on your mic. Yes, is it working now? Thank you, President. In accordance with ROP 544, I move that the bill should not be committed to the House Committee for consideration. Mr. Eddie Chu, proposed invoking RRP 54(4) to have on this bill. I will adjourn the meeting to consider this. Thank you.